top today that it's almost like dipping the toe in the water in terms of what we're coming up to over the next end of next week. Anyway, yes, it is a critical stage, but it's definitely not going to be the most critical stage in terms of defining GC at this Vuelta. What's going to be key today is that we need a real good team. And if we've got a good team, we're going to be able to achieve everything that we need to be able to achieve, keep Simon in a good position, and have him save energy. And that's what our objectives are based on today. I want to live, I want to kill.
I've been a miner for a heart of gold. I think today's my sort of cup of tea. Nice and birdie. I think today's going to be one of those ones to survive and try and do as much as you can in the short amount of time that I've got to help these guys. I don't quite go up hills like these guys, that's why. It's like when you go swimming. People float, but this is when I sink. I just go ka-plump.
Yeah, we'll see though. Looks like another hot day as always here. What else to say? I'm looking forward to getting stuck in, but yeah. 2 minute K before we get there, so we'll see.
What are you gonna do on your rest day?
Sweet FA. Sweet mother FA. Nah. Me and Simon, we were roomies in the Giro, roomies here again, and we had a bit of a tradition of basically sleeping in until midday on the rest day. On both rest days in the Giro, missed the group ride, missed breakfast, woke up at about 11:30. So if I can do that, I'll be living the dream.
It's at least 6 hours far away, so we need to climb quite a lot today, so it's probably 4,200 meters far away on climbing.
But yeah, we do some high altitude today, so luckily it's not going to be so hot. At least that's a good point of climbs.
Yeah, stage 9 today, the first real big mountain stage of this year's Vuelta. Colavetta is quite a famous climb in the Vuelta. I've done it many years in the past. Very exposed climb and very windy, so it's going to be real important that we've got a good team support for Simon there in that final. And that's sort of our main focus, is to just have as many guys as possible with him right up until we get to those last couple of kilometres.
No, we've got him 6k to go. The most crucial part of the race to get a cold bottle of water, so we thought we'd put him under a bit of pressure today.
After his performance yesterday?
He did well. He got three bags away, so give him another chance to get a bottle to everyone on the last climb.
Yeah, I know. I'm a bit worried about it today. Right at the top, and make sure we're not in the cutoff zone.
Stage 9 and the final battle in the opening phase of the Vuelta before the first rest day. The destination, a mountaintop finish at La Covetilla, taking the peloton to almost 2,000 metres above sea level. Through the little Spanish villages and with cobblestones to contend with, King was on the charge. Back in the main peloton, it was Rafael Majka controlling things for Emmanuel Buchmann. King, the winner of Stage 4, the winner of Stage 9. The battle for the minor placings and the race for the red jersey, Lopez across the line. It was then a little further back, Simon Yates, who did enough to move into the race lead by just 1 second. Yates leads 1 second clear of Alejandro Valverde, followed by Nairo Quintana, Emmanuel Buchmann, as the race heads into its first rest day.
Oh, we've been all around the world following these guys. They're excellent. They're having some really good rides this year. It is, yes, a hard day. It's definitely a Simon day today. Carry on my wayward son. There'll be peace when you are done. Lay your weary head to rest. Don't you cry no
more. The guys in front of me, I think three of the five, you can correct me after. Three of the five are altitude natives, so finishing quite high here, 2,000 metres, makes a difference. But I wasn't that far behind, a couple of seconds, so all good, looking forward to the rest day.
Simon's in the red, there you go. I think I heard something a couple of K to go, couldn't be too sure. That's awesome. Yeah, nice. Going into the rest day. He's obviously feeling really good, so that gives us a lot of confidence in him.
Yeah, wasn't really, wasn't looking for it. That's how it goes, I guess. I don't know what to say. Going to the rest day on a high.
Pretty hard day, and quite surprising to cross the line and figure out that Simon has the red jersey. Better to have it than not have it, I guess. But we're going to have to change our plans a bit going into the next couple of days and weeks. We definitely weren't expecting it. Definitely wasn't planned, but we'll take it while we have it.
It's a pretty brutal day. What do we got here? 4,314 meters of climbing, so it's pretty demanding, and the temperatures were hot again. So yeah, another tough day.
It was a nice day in the office, 6 hours for me, not for the best, but it's fine. Simon took the red, so tonight we can have red wine. Never mix the colors, only red tonight.
El aplauso para Simon Yates del equipo.
Was that the plan, mate?
No, it wasn't, but no, it wasn't. Oh, not really. I mean, we've only got it by 1 second, and we saw today the guys like Rigoberto Urán and Quintana obviously climbing really well, so it's all very, very tight, and really having the jersey by 1 second, it's not going to change the plan. In fact, it's kind of good, you know, a little bit of unexpected publicity, something good for the morale. So we'll take it.
I don't really know what's going on, to be honest. I think like you suffer and you do everything, and then you hear that Simon's taking the jersey, so you got to be stoked, but at the same time, look. Yeah. Now, which one's this? Can I have 6 or can I have 10?
What you want.